We're going to import images or photos to the storyboard, and then we're going to add music under those images to serve as the actual movie or video. I find that musicians do this a lot to feature their music on YouTube or on the internet, where in this case uploading MP3 files or WAV files may not be possible. To begin, we're going to add some photos to the storyboard, which I've already done. You can go to add videos and photos, and then you can add them onto the storyboard. Next, we're going to add some music, so we're going to click add music. We're going to choose a track, and then we're going to go to project, and then click fit to music. You can see that the music track is unchanged, but the image has been extended so that it fits right under the music track. Let's try adding two or more photos and see what happens. Go ahead and erase that. Alright, we're gonna add some photos again. Let's try adding two or more photos in here. We're gonna case one, add three. And then we're gonna add the music track, so we click add music. And then we're gonna go to project and fit to music. The music track is left unchanged, but these photos have been extended. The duration of these photos have changed to make sure that it fits under the music track. For best results, make sure that your track is long enough so that the images can fit right under it pretty easily. Again, musicians do this a lot to feature their videos on YouTube or on the internet, where in the case MP3 files or WAV files cannot be uploaded on certain sites like YouTube. YouTube only features videos and not MP3 files. So featuring your music this way is the best idea possible.